Well, friends, welcome to session two of Compassion Camp. In our last session, we focused on what it meant to come to the table and be compassionate for other people. This session, it's about being brave and what it means to be brave in caring for and loving our neighbor as Jesus did. Being brave is sometimes not the easiest thing. In my own life, really for a good part of my first half of my life, if not longer, I was not one who, I was very risk averse, let's put it that way. I remember opportunities to get on ropes courses and do some of those kinds of things. And honestly, I made up things so that I wouldn't have to do it because I was scared. I wasn't brave enough to take the chance. To truly be compassionate to others and to care for others really does take bravery because it takes us putting ourselves out for someone else. You're going to hear a story read by one of the families in our church here in just a few minutes. But there's so many of the stories in the Bible. But another one in particular that comes to mind, the story, it's known as the Good Samaritan. It took bravery for that third person who came by to stop and to care and to do all that he did to care for the one who was hurting. In the write-up for this session, it gave some opportunities or scenarios about being brave. Like Mia has extra food in her pantry. She can be brave and do what with it? Taylor's a lifeguard. When someone's struggling in the water, Taylor can be brave and... Jaden sees a friend picking on a younger child. Jaden can be brave and... Sam notices the teacher never calls Kai by the name they prefer. Sam can be brave and... Miss Perez notices her students are restless and need a break. Miss Perez can be brave and... Dr. Gwynn hears some people need medical care but can't afford it. He can be brave and... So with each one of those scenarios, for them to take action, there is a step of bravery that's required. Some of them may feel like it's a bigger step than others, but all of them are steps of bravery. There's a song that they have about being brave, and I'm going to play that, have that in this video here just after I'm done here. But as I read the words to that song, it inspired me, it called me back to another song that's going to form the basis of our meditation time. That there's especially one part of it that there's one line in particular from this song that asks the question, are you tough enough to be kind? I think you can substitute brave. Are you brave enough to be kind? Are you brave enough to truly have compassion for somebody else? So take a listen to this song and then the scripture reading shared by a family in our church.
One day, Jesus visited someone's home. Everyone had heard he was there. They were so excited because they had heard he had healed and helped people be a part of their communities again. A friend who was paralyzed had his friend take him to see Jesus. When the group got there, it was so crowded. There was no way to get to Jesus through all the people. They had an idea. They climbed up onto the roof of the house and made a hole in the roof right above where Jesus was. They then lowered their friends into the room. When Jesus saw their face, he was...
Okay.
He told their friend, I see you and love you. you are made whole for your community. Your sins are forgiven. Some temple leaders called scribes were watching Jesus. When they heard him say this to his friend who was paralyzed, they were they thought to themselves, who is this Jesus? Who do you think he is? Only God can say these things. Jesus could tell the scribes disagreed with him. So they said, what he said to them. Some temple leaders called scribes for watching Jesus. When they heard him say this, the friend who was paralyzed, they thought to themselves, who does Jesus think he is? Only God can say these things. Jesus could tell the scribes disagreed with him. So he said to them, I know what you're thinking right now, but what's easier, to say, I see you and love you, or get up and walk? I'll show you that it's possible to do both. With?
Okay.
Jesus came to the friend who was paralyzed and said, get up, pick up your mat, and go home. You are healed now. He stood up. He picked up his mat and went home with his friend. Everyone was so
happy.
They praised God because they had never seen anything like this before.
As we come to our time of meditation and just praying about what's next, I want to offer to you a couple of opportunities. Sometimes we need to recognize when bravery is being shown. So who is someone that you can write a note to this week or place a phone call to them and thank them for the bravery that they show? Maybe to a first responder, just literally just writing a note and giving it to a police officer that you see. It might be someone who's speaking up for the underrepresented or the voiceless. It might be someone who's just quietly doing the work of God in the world and not really expecting much recognition. Maybe it's someone else entirely. But who can you recognize for the bravery that they show? And what can you learn from their example of bravery? The card, the daily examine that I encourage you to use each day has a simple prayer. God of courage, you help us to be brave, to trust, and to follow. Make us instruments of your help and your healing. Can you pray that each day? Can you pray that each day over these next 2 weeks? So for our meditation, I'm going to play a song. Now, many of you know that U2 is like, you know, my go-to for music a lot of the time. And they have a song that's called 13, There is a Light. And that's the one that in the first part of the video I mentioned about has that one lyric, one line that says, are you tough enough to be kind? And I want to start with that, but just take a few moments. Take a few big, deep breaths. If it helps, maybe do a rhythm of inhale for 4 seconds, hold for 4 seconds, exhale for 4, hold for 4, and repeat that several times over. In the video, I'm just going to have some images of light and darkness. And I encourage you to just let this music and let these lyrics and let these images just surround you. And remind you of the light that is always there, the light that we can reach towards, the light that fills us as we live out the bravery to which we are called.
And if the terrors of the night come creeping into your days, and the world comes stealing children from your room, guard your innocence from hallucination. And know that darkness always gathers around the light. There is a light we can't always see. If there is a world we can't always be. If there is a dark that we shouldn't doubt. And there is a light, don't let it go. When the wind screams and shouts, and the sea is a dragon's tail, and the ship that stole your heart away sets sail, when all you've left
someone like